Hey everyone, Shabby Gamer here, and welcome back to another episode of our WWE 2K16 Universe Mode, and this is going to be our last episode of Thunder. Of course, we do still have the Elimination Chamber pay-per-view coming up this Sunday, but as we discovered recently, we are going to be stopping this Universe Mode after Battleground and starting a brand new one based on the new rosters in the WWE with Raw, SmackDown, and NXT. So let's have a quick look at the last card we're going to have for our last Thunder episode. We're going to start things off with a match here between Dolph Ziggler and Sheamus. Now, the winner of this match will be put into the Elimination Chamber match on Sunday, where we already know Matanza will be in there, of course, defending his championship. And last week, Sting and Paul White, the Giant, both qualified as well. Then we've got Nikki Bella taking on Carmella. Then we have another Elimination Chamber qualifier match. We've got Booker T, Apollo Crews, Baron Corbin, Jack Swagger, Rob Van Dam, and Bad News Barrett. We've got the New Day, the Tag Team Champions, taking on the Wyatt family, Luke Harper and Eric Rowan. We're going to see the Fighting Irish taking on the Outsiders, Kevin Nash and Scott Hall. Matanza Cueto, the Thunder Champion, takes on Abyss. And then our final match this evening, another Elimination Chamber qualifier, Randy Orton, Bray Wyatt, Mil Muertes, and the former Thunder Champion, Cactus Jack. So we are just going to watch the three matches this evening. It is going to be the three qualifying matches, so we'll skip Nikki Bella versus Carmella, and it's a win for Nikki Bella. We will skip the New Day versus the Wyatt family, or a win for the Wyatt family. Well, there you go, ladies and gentlemen. The Wyatt family are now the number one contenders for the Tag Team Championships at Elimination Chamber. I'm looking forward to that, actually. Wyatt family versus the New Day. Maybe we can go for something a little bit different. Maybe a Tornado Extreme Rules match. The New Day have held the belts ever since day number one. Can they be the only ever-present champions in the Universe Mode? Or can the Wyatt family take the champions in the last episode? That'd be an interesting thing to find out tomorrow. The Fighting Irish versus the... Wow. The Fighting Irish pick up a victory over the Outsiders. It's a crack in that one. And surely, yes, Matanza Cueto, the Thunder champion, picks up the win over Abyss. So now we have three matches left. We've got Ziggler versus Sheamus. We've got the six-man battle royal. And we have the Fatal 4-Way Extreme Rules match. So without further ado, let's get straight into our first match. So as we said, our first match is going to be Dolph Ziggler taking on Sheamus, and the winner of this match will be put into that Elimination Chamber match for the Thunder Championship this Sunday. And here we go, Seattle, Washington. Is that right? I don't know. I don't think Seattle was in Washington, is it? I don't know. I don't know. Let's just ignore that. Let's just pretend that never happened. Dolph Ziggler then. Dolph Ziggler, a man who... very surprisingly, got the number one contendership for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. I was so surprised about that, actually. I watched it, not live, obviously, but I watched it first thing in the morning. In the UK, Raw and SmackDown start at 1 a.m. Because obviously they're shown live in America and they're shown live here at 1 a.m. So I did get up early to watch it before work. And I must admit, I was stunned when Ziggler won that six-man match. I did not expect it. I expected... going into that match, Bray Wyatt to win. I thought Bray Wyatt versus Dean Ambrose for SummerSlam would have been money, really. You could have just taken money, but I think it was a wise move. I know a lot of people have been moaning about Ziggler getting the opportunity, but I think if Wyatt had the chance, I don't think it would have been special. I think the whole thing between Wyatt and Dean Ambrose could be a really good storyline that could go over a few months. So that's why I'm sort of happy that they didn't go with Wyatt. They could have gone with AJ Styles. That would have been a pretty good match as well. But I don't think they want to put AJ Styles under again because he's already lost a few pay-per-views this year. So he needs to get himself a big win, I think. Cena, I think, would have just been a bit predictable. Baron Corbin, maybe a little bit too soon. So really, you look at it and there wasn't a lot of options. We know that Ziggler's going to end up losing the match. He's not going to win the match. He's not going to win the championship, I don't think. So I think it just gives him a chance to really just settle down and then build up some really good feuds going forward from SummerSlam. Of course, Randy Orton's already tied up as well against Brock Lesnar, so he couldn't be involved. So I think really having Ziggler get in the match probably was the best bet. They could have used Del Rio. Del Rio wasn't even in the six-man match, which is a bit of a surprise. The one thing that annoyed me about the first episode of SmackDown, I don't know if this is the same for you, of course Raw... we saw the debut of Finn Balor straight away, which we were pretty happy about. And we saw the debut of Nia Jax. Happy about that as well. SmackDown, on the other hand, We didn't see the debut of Alexa Bliss or Cormella in the ring. They came out and did this dodgy little talking bit. So we didn't see either of them two in the ring. And we also didn't see the debut of American Alpha in the ring either. So I was a little bit annoyed. I was hoping to see those all in the ring for their debuts. I think it looks like, well, American Alpha are definitely going to be in a match next week. So I'm looking forward to that one. Carmella and Alexa Bliss, I should imagine they might try and do like some sort of fatal four-way, or I think SmackDown need to establish themselves their own women's division and their own tag division as well. That looks like the sort of possibility, and I'd be interested to see what happens on SmackDown this week as well, to see obviously Rhino made his debut last week. I'm assuming that means that Rhino's going to be a permanent member of the SmackDown roster, and I'm thinking this Heath Slater thing is going to continue on. You know, Heath Slater on SmackDown did a little promo, got attacked by Rhino. I think he goes to Raw, does the same little promo, and gets attacked by Jinder Mahal, for example, because Jinder Mahal has been rumoured to have signed with WWE, and he's going to be coming back to the Raw brand. And then maybe he goes back to SmackDown the next night, and he does the same promo and gets attacked by Curt Hawkins, who, again, is somebody who's rumoured to have re-signed and be joining up the SmackDown roster. I think they'll just continue doing that for a while, you know. It seems like a clever way of bringing all these people back to the roster. A bit like what you did with the Legends a few years back. So about that, two guys here. I think, where is Sheamus now? Sheamus is on Raw, isn't he? I don't know where Sheamus is, actually. He's in Raw or SmackDown. I know, obviously, Ziggler's on SmackDown. I think Sheamus might be in Raw. I'm interested as well to see Seth Rollins versus Finn Balor, because I think that has the potential to be an absolute incredible, incredible match. Those two, I think that's going to be a fantastic match. And again, I think Ziggler versus Ambrose is going to be pretty good as well. As probably will... Well, Lesnar versus Orton, I'm not sure. They've never wrestled each other before in the past, have they? So it's a brand new first-time match. So it'll be interesting to see just how it pans out. This is a massive match for both of these two guys. They've been given a real good opportunity here. The other people that are trying to qualify for this match have been given more difficult ways to get in. Of course, we've got a six-man over-the-top rope battle royal. And, of course, we also have the Fatal 4-Way Extreme Rules match later. So these guys know that it's only one opponent they have to get past to get into that Elimination Chamber. Although, of course, do you really want to be locked inside a cell with Matanza Cueto? That's the interesting one. Do you really want to be locked in a cell with Matanza Cueto? That sounds like a very dangerous place to be, if you ask me. Not sure I want to be in a cell with Matanza Cueto. Sheamus fighting back with that boot to the face, and then that diving shoulder block taking Ziggler down. Sheamus now bringing Ziggler back up to his feet, up onto his shoulders, looking for a little bit of white noise, and hits it. Or if you're an indie fan, then the air raid slam, I think that's called. Sheamus now big belly-to-belly suplex, and Ziggler's struggling here. But Ziggler throwing Sheamus into the corner. There's the big splash. And can Ziggler pull this one off, bringing Sheamus back up to his feet? Big super kick. Sheamus drops to the ground like a sack of spuds. One, two. Oh, and Sheamus kicks out. Ziggler can't believe it. Both back up to their feet now. Sheamus sending Ziggler all the way over the top, crashing to the ground below. Sheamus now taking the top off the announce table. I don't know if that's a wise move. You need to get Ziggler down and pinned as quickly as possible, because you've got to remember, not only do you need to win this match to get into the Elimination Chamber, but if you do win this match, you've only got 3 or 4 days until the Elimination Chamber. So you don't want this to be too much of a match, because you want to make sure you go into that chamber 100%. So announce tables, ring steps, probably the best to try and avoid them, really. But you try and tell these guys that. Ziggler slides back into the ring. And now back out as well. I'll tell you what would be a nice feud to watch. And I don't know if you guys agree with me on this one, but on SmackDown, I want to see Dolph Ziggler versus AJ Styles in a feud. I think that'd be quite good. Randy Orton as well. We need to see Randy Orton get involved in some new stuff. Maybe Randy Orton versus Dean Ambrose for the championship, or what about Randy Orton versus Baron Corbin? And that's an interesting feud as well. Wow, big super duper whooperplex by Dolph Ziggler. Sheamus is down, and he's really down. If Ziggler slides back into the ring, he's not going to. He's going to take Sheamus in with him. That's what I said. Of course, we've got the Elimination Chamber this Sunday. These guys need to protect themselves, and Sheamus being caught with that super duperplex and Ziggler now being thrown into ring posts and now thrown into the apron as well, it's not helping either of their bodies. They're not going to be going into this cell at a full 100%. Referee's up to a 7 count now. Sheamus taunting the grounded Ziggler, who does slide back into the ring. Ziggler. There's that big jawbreaker. Can Ziggler pull this one off? He's up into the middle right. Referee telling Ziggler to come down. And he does, but he comes down elbows first into the face of Sheamus. Now bringing Sheamus back up to his feet, but Sheamus playing possum, shoulder block, taking Ziggler down. Now Sheamus bringing Ziggler back up. Over that top rope once again. These two guys doing now, they're back to the outside. Sheamus belly to belly suplex on Ziggler on the outside. It's going to be a painful move once again for Ziggler, who now really gets launched into the ring there by Sheamus. Ziggler being taken down once again by Sheamus. Front chantry now by Sheamus into the snapmare. And a big kick to the face of Ziggler. We know that Ziggler's had issues in the past with concussions, and that's not going to help things. And oh, look at that. Big Irish curse backbreaker. Sheamus dropping into the pin. He left it a little bit too long there, and Ziggler does manage to get a hold of that bottom rope. Sheamus not happy at all, but there's the rules. It's a rope break, and now Sheamus. I think Ziggler might be wise to stay down here, though. Sheamus, bro kick. Ziggler down. Looks to be out. Sheamus dropping into the pin. 1, 2, and 3. And there we go. Sheamus picks up the victory. There was no way Ziggler was going to kick out of that bro kick. Like I said, he's had issues in the past with concussions, and that's not going to help his situation at all. That's why we're sort of surprised that he got another opportunity, because that's been his issue in the past. I think Ziggler, by rumor, I don't know if this is true or not, is only 1 or 2 concussions away from being, not necessarily banned, but being told by WWE he's no longer allowed to wrestle, but for health reasons. Let's hope that does not happen, but working with guys like Sheamus is not going to help Ziggler, really. I like Ziggler. I'm happy that Ziggler's been given the opportunity to have that match at SummerSlam. I really am. And I think that's just a way for the I think that's a way for the new writers of SmackDown to try and get the fans on their side straight away, because they know that Ziggler has a very strong fan base but hasn't really been given an opportunity over the last few years. So to give him this chance is a real clever move by the new writers to try and get people on side. And it's a good win. It's a good win for Sheamus. He now joins Matanza Cueto, Sting, and the giant Paul White inside that Elimination Chamber. We're going to have 2 more people joining them. But Sheamus now knows that he's going to have a chance to walk out of this Universe mode on Sunday, forever being the Thunder Champion. And here is our second match of the evening. It's another Elimination Chamber qualifier. We've got Booker T, we've got Baron Corbin, Apollo Crews, Rob Van Dam, Jack Swagger, and of course, Bad News Barrett. And here we go. Obviously, we'll try and skip through some of these entrances a bit quicker, because 6 entrances is maybe a little bit too much to really go through. But of course, our first entrant is going to be Baron Corbin, a guy who's been okay in this universe mode, actually, and I think he's really going to thrive now in the smaller rosters. I think he's going to get a lot more opportunity. Of course, he was part of the six-part challenge on SmackDown recently, so I think he's probably going to get more opportunities going forward, so that's a good thing. I was never really a fan of Baron Corbin in NXT. I thought he was just a bit too much. I didn't think he was quite as talented as some of the other people, but for some reason, as soon as he moved up onto the main roster, I quite enjoyed watching him. I don't know what it is. I think I've just got an allegiance with NXT guys. I might not like them down in NXT, but as soon as they get moved up, I want to see them do well. And Baron Corbin is someone that has really found himself a place on the roster. And it'd be interesting to see just how he keeps going on in the future. I'm thinking maybe, I know it might be a bit quick, but Baron Corbin versus Dean Ambrose in a championship feud would be pretty good, I think. I know it's a bit early for him, but I think Baron Corbin versus Dean Ambrose would be a good little feud. And entrant number two into the match is going to be, I can't remember all of the ring. It's going to be Jack Swagger. The real American Jack Swagger. Another guy that I think will really be advantaged by having this roster split. He's going to get a lot more chance now on the main roster to show what he can do. I honestly can't remember where he's gone. Is he in a... Did he go to Raw or did he go to SmackDown? I don't even know. I don't even know where Jack Swagger went, to tell the truth. But either way, I think he's going to get a lot more chance now again. The rosters are smaller, and that's the best thing, really, because people are going to get a lot more airtime now. People like Heath Slater got himself a full promo on SmackDown. That just shows how well the roster split is going to work for some of these guys. Jack Swagger, you never know. Jack Swagger really thrived in the last roster split. That's when he was the champion of SmackDown on multiple occasions, I believe. Main evented WrestleMania as well, so you never know. He might be able to get back to those heights. He's still a pretty good wrestler. I think he just struggles with getting himself over and with letting Dutch Mantel go recently. I don't know if he's going to get much chance to work on that. And of course, here is another guy that's really going to have a big advantage from the roster split, and that is Apollo Crews. And again, he is a guy that was involved in the six-pack challenge. I forgot about him earlier on in SmackDown. So again, it looks like they're going to be putting him up to a decent level. To put Apollo Crews and Baron Corbin in that six-pack challenge and to leave Del Rio out really shows that they really want to try and put over some of these younger talents that are very, very good. Very, very good. And I'm hoping Apollo Crews is going to get some good airtime. I think Apollo Crews would end up being a fantastic Intercontinental Champion in the next 12 months or so. Not quite sure if he's really got the personality to go main event-wise, but I think he can definitely work on that. He's a very top-quality wrestler. He's fantastic in the ring, and it'd be interesting to see just how far he can go in SmackDown. I think as time goes on, he'll probably develop better and better. But I like him. I've met him a few times in the UK when he's been to wrestle, and he's a very, very good wrestler. Entrant number four is Rob Van Dam, a guy that I would not be surprised to see again in the WWE at some point. However, random drugs tests are not Rob Van Dam's strong point. Let's just say that. The man likes his weed. He really does, but there you go. Everybody has their vices, and unfortunately for RVD, his vice is something that means he cannot work for the WWE. But I wouldn't surprise me if he comes back for a short amount of time just to help put some of the younger talent over. And we're going to give an opportunity here because I think RVD in the Elimination Chamber would be pretty cool to see. You can imagine him a 5-star frog splash off the top of one of the pods. That'd be pretty damn awesome. And is this the fourth? Is this the fifth? Sorry, the sixth entrant. I can't remember now. Oh, that must be the fourth because there's still two left, isn't there? Because this is going to be Booker T, I believe. Is this Booker T? It is Booker T. Old style WCW Booker T. I was going to put the normal Booker T in, but I say the more up-to-date Booker T, shall I say. But I put this one in because he is in this roster with Stevie Ray. So, of course, that is the tag team. So I want them both to have the same attire, at least. So that's why we've got this Booker T in there. Plus, I think this Booker T is higher rated as well, anyway. That's one thing we'll do in our new universe mode. Anyway, we'll probably use some of the legends here and there to help put over some of the other talent. So we might bring back, say, The Undertaker for a quick feud building up to a pay-per-view. We might bring back Triple H on Raw to have a quick feud maybe with Seth Rollins or something along them sort of lines just to try and add a bit of variation because it's nice having the rosters in there, but every now and again we can bring back a legend. Maybe Edge. We can bring back Edge. Why not? He's not injured in our game, is he? Just injured in real life. And maybe even Mick Foley himself could get involved in a match as Cactus Jack. Who knows? Talking of noses, he's got one of the little things over his nose, help him breathe. And the last entrant into the match is our very first United States champion in this universe mode, Bad News Barrett. He's been very, very good in this universe mode, but sort of tailed off recently, sort of disappearing and not really getting a lot of action. So this is a great chance for Bad News Barrett to get himself back in the forefront and get himself an opportunity to get that Thunder Championship. It'd be interesting if he could do. It's a shame he did leave when he did, because again, if you look at the fact that Bad News Barrett, Cody Rhodes and Damian Sandow all left the WWE in the last few months, yet all three of them would have really thrived in this roster split. All three of them would have really got the opportunities they deserved in this roster split as well. Cody Rhodes could have ended up becoming a main event player. Damian Sandow could have at least got on television without having to make a fool of himself. And it wouldn't surprise me if those two do make a return in about a year's time. I wouldn't imagine for them to come straight back, but I would imagine that there's a possibility they could come back within about a year or so. Who knows? Once Cody Rhodes has ticked everything off his to-do list, it wouldn't surprise me if he does look to come back. And if the roster split is going to be a long-term thing, which I'm hoping it is, I really hope it is, because I'm a massive fan of the roster split, and I think if they can get a decent-sized roster on both shows, it's really going to help them out. And it should really cut down the amount of injuries, because people are not going to have to wrestle every single night. Because they can sort of split now. They can do one roster one night, one roster the other night. And it's going to really make things better. So, of course, the winner of this match will join Matanza Cueto, Paul White. Of course, the Big Show. Sting and Sheamus inside the Elimination Chamber. And that'll be five people then. And then, of course, we do have the sixth person being found out after this match in a fatal four-way Extreme Rules match. Randy Orton, Bray Wyatt, Mil Muertes, and Cactus Jack. So I've done a few of these six-man battle royals recently, and they do actually last quite some time. I think it's difficult to eliminate people sometimes, as RVD's trying to eliminate Apollo Crews just to prove me wrong. But I think it's a bit early for Apollo Crews to be knocked out of this one. I may be wrong. Apollo Crews is down in super quick time. Apollo Crews is out already. He is not happy with that. And we are down to five. So Apollo Crews is not going to be inside the Elimination Chamber. As RVD, a couple of big kicks caught both Baron Corbin and Bad News Barrett. And now Bad News Barrett looking to eliminate RVD. RVD fights his way free. Bad News Barrett throwing Rob Van Dam face first into the turnbuckle. And now he's got him up on the top rope. But RVD does manage to fight his way back. RVD now sending Bad News Barrett over the top rope. Jostling for position. And Bad News Barrett fights his way back into the ring. And now RVD throwing over the top rope. And it's just swings and roundabouts here. As soon as you try and eliminate someone, someone tries to eliminate you almost straight away. And you think these people would team up, wouldn't you, really? Bad News Barrett sit out, powerbomb on Booker T. The five-time WCW champion. It's Baron Corbin now trying to force Jack Swagger out via his boot. Swagger's back in, front chancery on Baron Corbin. Baron Corbin there with a Russian leg sweep. Big spike DDT there by RVD. And Rob Van Dam with a rolling thunder. I miss RVD, actually. I was a RVD in ECW was a lot better than what it was in WWE. I think it was the I think when people come to WWE, they get very much watered down in their style, and that was very much the same with Daniel Bryan. I think if Daniel Bryan has stuck with his original style he came to WWE with, well, the style he used to have in the indie scene, which was very slow, methodical, and very submission-based, he probably would still be wrestling. However, I think it was the fact that he changed his wrestling ability and became a lot more exciting in the ring that really pushed him to the level he was to get to where he was going, I suppose. He had to do what he did, I suppose. Swagger just colliding with the back of Booker T, and Baron Corbin has been eliminated, and we are down to our final four. Baron Corbin eliminated by Bad News Barrett. Jack Swagger now, knee to the chest of Booker T. Bad News Barrett with a couple of clubbing blows against the back of RVD, and now into a neckbreaker as well. Swagger just twisting the head of Booker T. Barrett wins a change on Rob Van Dam. Now, of course, we haven't named a number one contender as of yet for the United States Championship, and Pentagon will be defending that championship at Elimination Chamber. It's going to very much depend on who gets knocked out of these matches and who gets through, and then we'll just create ourselves a match. Probably going to be like a Fatal 4-Way match, or maybe even a 6-Way Ladder match, just to make it an exciting one, just to finish this Universe mode off. As I said earlier on, we are going to do the Wyatt Family versus the New Day for the Tag Team Championships. That's going to be one match. And then we'll decide what we're going to do. I think over with Nitro, we've already got our six-man Elimination Chamber decided. We've also got Kenny Omega versus Neville. And I think we've also got Jericho versus Del Rio, I believe. And that six-man Elimination Chamber over on Nitro is Samoa Joe, Brock Lesnar, Shinsuke Nakamura, Hideo Itami, CM Punk, and I always forget one. Kevin Owens it's going to be. So that's going to be a really good match as well. I think Elimination Chamber is really going to be such a fantastic pay-per-view, such a great way to end the Nitro and Thunder rosters. And then, of course, we'll continue on with Raw and SmackDown for a couple of weeks, and we'll finish off at the Battleground pay-per-view. And then by the time we finish off at Battleground, that should have given me enough time to create the new rosters for Raw, SmackDown, and NXT, so we can get straight into our new Universe mode, and we'll continue that all the way up until the release of 2K17, which I'm really looking forward to that now, actually. I have cancelled my pre-order on Amazon of 2K17, and I've reordered the newer NXT version with game. So I am going to get, of course, Apollo Crews, Nia Jax, and Shinsuke Nakamura on release day. I'm also going to get the Finn Balor figure, as well as some art and order. I'm not really bothered about any of that stuff. I just want to make sure I get Nakamura on release day. Nakamura, Apollo Crews, and Nia Jax. They are going to be available, if you're wondering, because I had to Google this now. If you're wondering and you're panicking about it, if you don't buy the NXT version, you can still get Nakamura, Apollo Crews, and Nia Jax as DLC. However, they're not going to be available for about at least a month or two. So you can still get them in the long run. You just have to wait for them. Because I was really worried about that. And then when I found out, I thought I might as well just get the NXT version anyway. But yeah, I was really worried that I was going to not be able to get them if I don't get the NXT version. And there goes Jack Swagger. We are down to our final three. Booker T, RVD, and Bad News Barrett. It's going to be interesting. Whoever gets through in this one, isn't it, really? This was very much going to be the wild card round, basically. There's a lot of different people in this one. Booker T, Apollo Crews, Baron Corbin, Jack Swagger, RVD, Bad News Barrett. Either way, these were all going to be wild cards. I think Bad News Barrett's probably the one that I would say is the least of the wild card. He's the one that I can see more in that match. However, like I said, Booker T is a several-time WCW champion. RVD, several-time champion as well. In WWE and ECW as well. And, of course, all across the indie scene as well. Barrett now bringing Booker T back up to his feet. I just completely forgot to talk there for a second. Looked like he was going to go for some sort of pump handle drop there, a pump handle slam. And Booker T managed to fight his way free. RVD with an Olympic slam almost. Now bringing Bad News Barrett back up to his feet. Over the top rope, can RVD eliminate Bad News Barrett? Barrett fights free. The big shoulder block to the gut of RVD. Now Booker taking RVD against the ropes. Look at that, RVD. That was clever, I've not seen that before. RVD just caught Booker T. Booker turned around straight into a wasteland, but a wasteland into a submission hold on the ground there by Bad News Barrett. Not seen them do that before. And it always gets a bit messy on this game when there's an odd amount of people in the match. So really now, here we go. Now finally, a bit of teamwork as both RVD and Booker T look to work together to take rid of Bad News Barrett. But Barrett held on and slid back into the bottom rope. I don't know if RVD's even noticed that yet. He's got his back to it. RVD now has Booker T up on the top. Is this going to be the end of Booker T in this match? No, Booker fights free. RVD nearly had him though. Booker sitting RVD against the rope, and now Bad News Barrett sending Booker over the top. Is this going to be the end of Booker T now by Bad News Barrett? He's already eliminated a couple of people in this match. And he's eliminated another one. We are down to our final two. It's Bad News Barrett and it's Rob Van Dam. RVD sending Bad News Barrett over the top rope straight away. Can RVD do it? No. Bad News Barrett fights free with that shoulder block to the gut. Great hesitant takedown. I can't talk this evening. I need to... You know what I need? I need some beer. I'm going to have some beer before the next match. Great standing moonsault there by Rob Van Dam. I'm trying to talk too quickly. It's these six men matches that really makes me struggle because I have to talk so quickly to try and get all of the action. RVD, big splash on Bad News Barrett. Has that taken enough out of him? Great standing shooting star press. Has that taken enough out of Bad News Barrett for RVD to be able to eliminate him? Another Hurricanrana. I think RVD needs to go for the elimination here, doesn't he? He needs to get Bad News Barrett eliminated as quickly as he possibly can. Both guys back up to their feet once again. RVD now taking Bad News Barrett up against the ropes. Trying to eliminate him once again. Can RVD get himself inside that elimination chamber? Bad News Barrett struggling here. He's on his tippy toes. And RVD, there's the dropkick. And there goes Bad News Barrett. We are down. And Rob Van Dam has secured his place inside the Hell in a Cell. So we now know it's going to be Matanza Cueto defending his championship against Sting, against Paul White, the Big Show, or the Giant, whatever you want to call him, Sheamus, and Rob Van Dam. We've got one more person to confirm for that match, and that is coming up right now in our main event. But well done to Rob Van Dam. He's one match away from becoming our Thunder Champion. And here is our main event for the last spot in the Thunder Championship Elimination Chamber match on Sunday. It's Randy Orton, Bray Wyatt, Mil Muertes, and Cactus Jack.
Whoa. I'm here.
Sorry, I was getting my beer out of the fridge and the whole thing just collapsed. So there we go. Right. There we go. Hopefully my beer will mean that I'll be able to talk properly now for the rest of this video. And I do need to record SmackDown straight after this as well. When we probably will have our Cruiserweight Championship match we've been teasing for a while. I believe, off the top of my head, it was going to be Phoenix, the Cruiserweight Champion, taking on... I think it was Tyson Kidd who got the number one contendership. So maybe we'll have that on SmackDown as well. I'm a little bit behind, as you can probably tell, so I'm trying to get these recordings up to date this weekend, so hopefully everything will be uploaded by end of play Sunday. So yeah, if you are watching this, then keep an eye on the channel if you are interested. We are going to have our next episode of SmackDown and our two episodes for the Elimination Chamber pay-per-view as well. And then I'm going to try and get the rest of the universe mode uploaded pretty quickly, because it's only going to be a couple of episodes a week for the next couple of weeks. But it means as well in the background that I can start working towards getting our NXT roster built up, and of course getting the extra guys we're going to need for Raw and SmackDown. I don't think there's many extra guys we need for Raw and SmackDown. Of course we need Rhino now. Well, I think we've already got Rhino in one of our rosters. I'm sure I used him for one of our rosters. I might be wrong. So that, of course, was Bray Wyatt. Next to make his entrance is going to be Mil Muertes. I really like the entrance attire of Mil Muertes. It does actually suit him quite well. If it wasn't for the tassly bits on the back of that, it would be absolutely perfect. But still, it does look pretty damn good. And who knows, Mil Muertes could be a real mover in this one. Of course, all these guys in this match are fighting for the last position in the Elimination Chamber match this Sunday. And Bray Wyatt takes a step outside the ring. Doesn't want to stay in the ring with Mil Muertes until he has to. I don't blame him, really. This guy is an absolute monster. Maybe not quite as much of a monster as Matanza Cueto, but that is yet to be seen. And here is entrant number 3 into the match. Randy Orton, a guy that, you know, I never really missed while he was out injured. He's been out injured now for some time, and I never really missed him. However, I must admit, when he's made his return, I'm actually quite happy to see him. So, I'm quite happy. Let's see how he gets on, I suppose. I'm hoping he'll do quite well. He's going to have this match against Brock Lesnar at SummerSlam. Then after that, then he'll be free to sort of go on and do whatever he wants to do. I think SummerSlam's in about 3 weeks' time, I believe. Which I'm really annoyed about, because I've been looking at my holiday dates. And I've got Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday off work. And SummerSlam's on the Monday night. So I'm really annoyed. Well, it's on the Sunday night going into the Monday morning. So I'm really annoyed about that. So I'm going to have to probably... get up early in the morning and watch SummerSlam before work. Or try and avoid SummerSlam and watch it when I get home. That might be a better way of doing it. Because I'm really looking forward to seeing Seth Rollins versus Finn Balor. That's going to be an incredible match. I'd love to watch it live, but I just can't stay up that late on a work night. But there you go, who knows? Who knows? And of course, the fourth and final entrant into this match is going to be Cactus Jack. And I'll tell you what, we're having a pretty long episode here this evening, aren't we? Considering it's only 3 matches, we're at 45 minutes already. Of course, I'm going to be cutting a chunk of that out for loading screens and bits and bobs like that for you guys. But still, after this Fatal 4 match, we're going to be looking at close to an hour, I reckon. Which is a bit of a long episode, really. But we have had a 6-man elimination over the top rope battle royal, whatever it's called. And of course, we are now going to have a Fatal 4-way as well. So we've really put all our cards on the table for this one. And it'd be interesting to see just which of these 4 guys will go on into that Elimination Chamber. We know Cactus Jack, the former Thunder champion, would love to get a hold of that belt once again. And he won the very original Elimination Chamber to win the Thunder Championship. So he'll be pretty confident because he knows that he can defeat the best in this roster already. Randy Orton had a torrid time in that very first Elimination Chamber because he just glitched to high hell everywhere, Randy Orton. At one point he was in the crowd. I don't know how that happened. But at one point he was in the crowd. Bray Wyatt, of course, brand new to this roster, moving from SmackDown a few weeks back after the Global Cruiserweight Championship. And of course, Mil Muertes as well. Pretty new to this roster after joining a few weeks back when we did Thunder Invades Lucha Underground. And it looks like we're going to have Mil Muertes and Bray Wyatt inside the ring as Cactus Jack and Randy Orton fighting on the outside of the ring. Of course, this is why I do the False Count Anywhere Fatal 4-way matches, because it means that the guys outside the ring can win the match as well. Because I know the way that they do these now is two people stay inside the ring and two people generally go outside the ring just to help split it up a little bit. And I think that's pretty, that's a good way of doing it. However, it means that only the two people inside the ring can win normally. So by doing a false count anywhere one, it keeps it a little bit more open. As Bray Wyatt resting those steps away from Milne Werther, now hitting him in the face with them as well. And Bray Wyatt is no stranger to weaponry. He knows very well how to use his environments. As of course does Cactus Jack. But Milne Werther, again, if you've seen any of his work over in AAA, Milne Werther of course is also Judas Messias, who I think worked in TNA for a little bit of time, or El Messias, he's known as well. And some of his AAA matches, hardcore matches, have been absolutely brutal. Really incredible matches, like with light tubes and all sorts. Guys Vampiro and Chessman, and some really aggressive opponents over in AAA. So he knows very well how to use the weaponry. And there was Bray Wyatt with the pin. Referee incredibly slow to get down and try and count, but Milne Werther's are kicked out in time. Randy Orton are just destroying Cactus Jack with that ladder. And now dropping Cactus onto the ladder with the backdrop as well. Cactus bouncing off onto the ground afterwards. Werther's now sending Bray Wyatt into the barricade. As Cactus now just dragging Randy Orton along into that corner. And there's just the punches to the face of Randy Orton, who drops to the ground. And so far, it looks like Cactus Jack is dominant, and as is Milne Werther. Cactus with a rake to the eye of Randy Orton. And now a Russian leg sweep as well on the outside. As Milne Werther is just sending Bray Wyatt straight into these chairs. And all hell just breaks loose in these matches, don't they? But you know at Sunday, six men are going to be locked inside that massive steel structure. There's nowhere else to go, nowhere to run. So you need to want to win this match as well, really. Because you know you're going to be locked inside that massive steel container with Matanza Cueto. You know you're going to be locked in there with Sheamus and RVD and Sting. A lot of guys that can do a lot of damage. And of course, Paul White, the Big Show as well. Milne Werther's with a pin here on Bray Wyatt. Is it going to be enough? Oh, God, that was close. That was really close. As now Cactus Jack with a baseball bat just levering the ground of Randy Orton, who's straight back up on his feet though. Bray Wyatt now back center on Milne Werther. Drops into a pin. One, two. It's only a two count. Bray Wyatt now just twisting the head of Milne Werther as Randy Orton just slamming Cactus Jack into the ring steps. Bray now just twisting the head of Milne Werther as well. Not a good place for Werther to be. As he slammed back of the head first into the mat now as well. And Bray Wyatt's in firm control of this one now. You feel that he's just only one Sister Abigail away from confirming his place inside that cell. We already know that his boys, Luke Harper and Eric Rowan, are going to get a tag team championship match at Elimination Chamber. And Bray will be hoping that he can get himself in that Elimination Chamber as well. The Wyatt family could end up this universe mode dominating the silverware here in Thunder. As Milne Werther's lining up Randy Orton here. Randy groggily getting back up to his feet. What is Mil looking for? Has him by the throat. Takes him up into a big choke slam. Drops into the pin. Cactus doesn't see it. Now he does. Is he going to get there in time? No, oh, he doesn't need to as Randy Orton just kicks out. Oh, wow. Forearm there by Milne Werther now spins Randy Orton round, takes him up, full Nelson onto a baseball bat. All four guys now back in the ring. Cactus Jack with a big face buster from the middle rope on Bray Wyatt. In for the pin he goes. One, two. Oh, and Cactus nearly gets it as well. Big boot to the knee of Randy Orton. There's Bray Wyatt now inside the ring with a Saito suplex on Cactus Jack. Randy Orton taking Mil Muertes down, and Bray in the middle of the ring with that big front slam. There's the pin. One, two, three, and that's it. Bray Wyatt's got himself in the match. Randy Orton and Mil Muertes just couldn't get back in the ring quickly enough, and Bray Wyatt picks up the victory. So it's very possible that the Wyatt family could dominate the gold by the end of Elimination Chamber. Eric Rowan and Luke Harper are going for the Tag Team Championships. Bray Wyatt is going for the Thunder Championship. He's going to be locked inside the cell, and that is really going to make things interesting. Wow. What an evening this has been. It's taken us 50-odd minutes to get there, but we now know all six members of that Elimination Chamber match for this Sunday. Of course, if you have forgotten, it's going to be Matanza Cueto defending against Sting, Paul White, The Big Show, Sheamus, Rob Van Dam, and Bray Wyatt. Of course, the entrance into that match will be completely random, so that's going to be a big impact on some of these guys. Also remember that we will be having a United States Championship match at Elimination Chamber as well. Still unsure how we're going to play that one out, whether we do a Fatal 4-Way just like this match, or whether we do a 6-man ladder match. I'm unsure as yet. I'm thinking along the lines of a Fatal 4-Way, because the ladder match is a little bit glitchy still. A bit difficult with people just standing there watching people grab the belt and sit down, rather than actually trying to actually stop them. So I think we'll definitely probably go for a 4-Way match probably. And there we go, there is the final. Bray Wyatt drops to his knees. You can see how happy he is. Bray Wyatt's got a chance to take over Thunder here with his Wyatt family. Well, guys, that is the end of this episode. I hope you have enjoyed it. Of course, if you have, then please do hit that like button. And of course, if you're new around here, be sure to hit that subscribe button as well, because we have got another episode of SmackDown coming up for you very, very soon. And of course, our Elimination Chamber pay-per-view should be uploaded by End of Play Sunday as well. So keep an eye out for that. Of course, we are winding this Universe Mode down now. We've only got a couple of weeks left of it, and then we'll start our brand new Universe Mode with the new rosters from Raw, SmackDown, and NXT from real life. And of course, we might just exaggerate here and there where we need to, just to try and keep things a little bit more entertaining for us as well. I've been Shabby Gamer. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you very, very soon for our next episode of SmackDown.